नमस्ते, वेलकम टू बीटीयू ई शिक्षण प्रोग्राम. आई डॉक्टर दाक्षायणी आर पाटिल वेलकम यू वंस अगेन फॉर द कोर्स बिल्डिंग सर्विसेज 3, 18 ARC 63. एंड दिस इज अ वंडरफुल इनिशिएटिव बाय विश्वेश्वरैया टेक्नोलॉजिकल यूनिवर्सिटी ई लर्निंग सेंटर. वी आर करेंटली डूइंग मॉड्यूल्स 1 एंड 2 एंड दिस इज Lecture number 11, dealing with air filtration systems in the air conditioning systems. So filtration, air filtration is the objective to be understood here. Previously, under module 2, we have completed so far introduction to air conditioning systems, the principle behind AC systems, the working principle, the types. Five types under unitary AC and central air conditioning, two types. Then we did ducting and air distribution system design for AC systems, that is large scale central AC. Today, lecture number 11, we will look at air filtration systems. And under this, what learning objectives we will look at air filtration. Salient aspects of the whole concept of filtering the air. What are the methods of dust removal by the filtration system? Methods of testing the filters, efficacy of the filters used, and types of air filters. I hope that is it. Selection of air filters. So these are the aspects of learning in today's lecture session. Let us begin that. So, what does air filtration essentially mean? Cleaning of the air that we are breathing. So, keeping it safe, hygienic. For what reasons? We will take a look. Normally, outside fresh air and indoor air both are laden with dust and suspended impurities. Air is everywhere. We are breathing in the air, either outside or inside, but it is dispersed with impurities of various degrees and various quantum, varying quantum based on where we are. So the intent of air filtration system in air conditioning systems is to remove such impurities from the indoor air. So keeping the indoor environment safer, hygienic for us to breathe and to perform better or whatever work we are carrying out. Essentially, a normal human being spends 80 to 90% of time indoors. So this is the amount, between 80 to 90. The rest of it goes commuting or so, but even then you are in a vehicle. So, and a humans breathe approximately 7 to 8 liters of air. So 7 to 8 liters of air per minute. Then we derive 60% of energy from air. So that shows the criticality of the air and the quality that it has to be for us to breathe in to derive this 60% of energy. The rest is from diet and all that. So air filtration forms a very fundamental requirement in a good indoor environment. Hygiene and cleanliness of the air definitely is of paramount importance, because it is laden with lots of impurities unseen to the naked eye. Then we have the concept of clean rooms in air conditioning systems. These clean rooms are spaces or rooms which have zero tolerance for any kind of impurity. So the AC system that is designed has to be foolproof, providing extreme cleanliness of the air. We will be seeing this in the upcoming lecture. And these are very specialized air conditioning systems, for instance, in hospital ICUs, certain bio labs, right? So requiring foolproof cleanliness of the air. Now the impurities that we are talking about, which are laden or dispersed in the air, airborne dust, so we call, they come in three varieties or three classifications: coarse, fine, very fine, depending on the size of the impurity. So they range between 0.1 to 0.001 mm in diameter. So that is extremely small microns of dust particles that are embedded in the air. And the AC system should be designed for achieving that amount of cleanliness and warding the air clear from these impurities. And the type of impurities that are laden in the air range from sand, soot, ash, vegetable, the small aspects that are given away from the organic matter, lint from the clothing, from the fabric that we use, be it curtains, clothing, sofa cover, etc. Metal outputs, bacteria, microorganisms, viruses, radon, asbestos, etc. So the type of impurities in the air are ranging across all of these. And then we have studied in module 1 the concept of sick building syndromes, SBS, when a building is housing unclean air and we are breathing that in. So whenever a person is inside a faulty indoor environment or a faultily designed air conditioning system which is not maintained well, which is not filtering the air which is conditioned again and again and sent back into the room in the right manner, the persons occupying or working in those environments suffer from acute health symptoms, respiratory symptoms, breathing issues, skin irritation, eye issues, etc., nasal related asthmatic, etc. So, and when you go out of the building, you are fine. So it is acute, but prolonged exposure to such faulty and unsafe indoor air creates chronic illnesses. Hence, why is proper air cleaning necessary? Air cleaning, air filtering. One is protection of human health and comfort. The dust particles are related to serious respiratory ailments like asthma, etc. So these have to be cleared of the air that we are breathing. Hence, it is of importance to human health and comfort. Maintaining the cleanliness of a room in terms of the various surfaces and the furnishings, upholstery or the furniture, sofa, etc. Protection of the equipment. Processes that are particularly sensitive and require near clean air to operate properly. Computers, cutting edge machinery, certain equipment in hospitals which require very clean air to function or operate properly, and they need to function properly because of their direct impact on the human health or the processes that are happening. So these are basically the main reasons of why we have to provide the best air cleaning, air filtering mechanism in a AC system. Method of dust removal. How do we remove the dust from the air? So there are three types that we can adopt. One is impingement method of removing the dust, straining the dust. Third one, electrostatic precipitation. So first one, impingement. What does it mean? The air has to pass through the filters. It's an indicative graphical representation. The dots are the air part are the dust particles. So impingement refers to the dust particle getting adhered to the filtering medium. It getting stuck or holding on to the filtering media. The filtering media is going to have the dust adhered to it, stuck onto it. Second one, straining. So what happens is if the particle size is larger than the holes in the filtering media normally is a mesh. It is a network of fibers that have holes in them, interstices. If the interstice is smaller than the dust particle that is hitting it, the dust particle will be strained there. Similar to when you prepare tea for yourself, you are straining the tea. The tea powder remains on top and the lovely water in the glass for you to drink. Similarly, straining of the impurities. Third one, electrostatic precipitation. We adopt the method of electrostatic energy. So the air that is coming in is neutral. So we charge the air by letting it pass through a charging grid. So the particles either get positive or negative, and we pass it. Next stage of the filtering is through a set of two or three plates, positively charged, negatively charged plates. So what happens? Opposites attract. So the air particles which are positively charged get attracted to the negative plate and vice versa. And we use as an add-on impingement method to get the particle stuck to the plate and we clear it. So these are the three methods of removing dust from air that is passing through the filtration media in the air conditioning terminal unit. I hope it is clear. Impingement method, the impurity getting stuck to the filtering media. Straining, the impurities getting strained by the filtering media. It remains on the outside of the filtering media and does not enter the AC system when the air is moving through the cooling coil or the evaporator. So it is cleaned by the time it comes to the evaporator. Similarly, electrostatic precipitation, we are charging the air particles and electrostatic fields are put into use here. So, efficiency of air filters is measured by the percentage of particulate matter in air which is collected by the filter. So when we are going to rate the filters as 90% efficient, 99% efficient, it means the percentage of the particulate matter in air, the unwanted particles which are in the air, getting collected by the filter to be cleaned off, and clean air passes on to the evaporator. Methods of testing filters. One is a weight method. The weight of the dust captured by air filter is measured. First step, a standard dust of fixed concentration and particle sizes is used as a measuring parameter. This test is useful in comparing ability of the filter to remove larger particles. Okay. Now, if you see a clean filter and a dirty filter, this is how they will be seen. So this filter, which is arresting the impurities in the air, is going to get collected on the filter surface. So hence, it's very essential to service the filter frequently or as per the period suggested by the manufacturer. Frequent cleaning is a very, very important part of keeping the system clean. Second is the dust spot discoloration method. Dust spot discoloration. Air is passed through the air cleaning device and then it is passed through a wonderful white filter paper, purely white filter paper. All right. The degree to which the paper is discolored gives an indication of the amount of smaller dust particles which were not removed by the air cleaner. So, when the particle has managed to pass through the air filter, it means the air filter did not filter that those dust particles or those sized dust particles. It has passed through the filter successfully. So, now the white paper is telling us by the degree of discoloration it underwent. It's an important test as these particles cause soiling of room surfaces. Second advantage, these particles seem to stain the various surfaces in the room. You might have seen why some of the surfaces stain over a period of time. Because the air is laden with those impurities which are settling on the surface and eventually it discolors to brown, orange, green, black. So that is dust spot discoloration. Next, DOP penetration method. It is used to measure ability of air cleaners to remove extremely small particles. It is used to measure ability of air cleaners to remove extremely small particles. A cloud of particles of a substance called DOP is chemically generated up to the size of 0.3 microns in diameter. For information, 1 micron is 1 by 25,000th of 1 inch. That's the smallness of 0.3 microns. The particles not removed is measured by light scattering technique and then tested ahead. Alright, so that is the DOP penetration method. So bacteria, now to get a hang of how much sized are we looking at. Bacteria is around 0.3 to 30 microns. Cigarette smoke is 0.01 to 1 micron. So the DOP test used only on air cleaners designed to have a high efficiency in removing very small scaled particles. So it's an extreme test to sense filters which have to filter smallest of small particles. They are very essential in places like hospitals and large gathering spaces, mass gathering, especially in COVID times, all the more important. The fourth method is dust holding capacity. Now the first three tests measure efficiency of air cleaner in removing the particles, but not how much the filter air resistance increases with dust accumulation. Recollect the picture with the filter, clean filter, and the filter with the clogged filter. So when a filter is clogged with the dust impurities, it will give resistance to the airflow. So if your AC unit, window AC, has the gridiron air grill, now the filters are clogged with dirt. So it is going to have resistance to the airflow. So the supply air might not be coming into the space at the required velocity because it is resisted by the filter. If at the return air grill filters are there, now the air is going to hit the filter and get back into the room. So there is a backdrop draft of dirty air back into the room. So dust holding capacity compares the weight of the dust collected with the increase in air resistance to the filter. So that parameter is going to be tested by this particular methodology of the testing, dust holding capacity. Now let us get a perspective on the types or the sizes of relative sizes of the impurities. Human hair, 100 microns. 1 micron is approximately 1/100th of a centimeter or 1/25,000th of an inch. Smallest size particle to be seen with the naked eye is around 20 microns. Human blood corpuscle is 10 micron. Tobacco smoke, 1/4 a micron. So, and viruses are much below that. So that is a range of impurities we are encountering, and we need to have a AC filtration system adapted to remove whatever is intended to be removed from that particular space. It is subjective to the place we are talking about, building we are talking about. Now let us start looking at the types of air filters that can be used. Pre-filters or sieve filters or screen filters, first type. Second type, fine filters. Third type, absolute filters or high efficiency particulate air filters. HEPA filters, very popularly called as absolute filters or as HEPA filters, high efficiency particulate air filters. Then fourth type, the electronic filters. It is one of the type of filtration, if you remember. Electronic filters where we charge the air and we use electrostatic field to arrest the impurities. Alright, so we will look at each of these individually ahead. Pre-filters, also called as sieve or screen filters. The filtering media will not allow dust particles to pass through. So that only infers that the filtering media is a mesh. It is a crisscross of fibers with holes in between them. The holes are the interstices. So this media is not going to allow the dust particles pass through. So that means the dust particle size has to be bigger than the interstice. So the filtering media is designed to arrest certain level of impurities in the air. So accordingly the sizes of the interstices are there. Since the interstices of a screen type filter must be smaller than the smallest particle to be filtered, these filters offer high resistance to airflow. Right? Now the holes are getting clogged with the impurities that get stuck to it. And over the period of time, it is going to offer high resistance to the airflow. The resistance increases as the media gets covered with dust. The resistance to the airflow increases as the media gets covered with dust. There is a concept called as viscous impingement method. So what does it mean? In the beginning slide we had seen three types of possibilities of arresting the impurities: impingement, straining and electrostatic. So impingement was adhering of the dust to the filtering media. How do we do it? So we use filtering media of coarse fibers is coated with a viscous adhesive. Viscous adhesive is a sticky, oily, resin-like of substance. So the filter is coated with this kind of adhesive. And we use glass fibers and metal screens as the filter. Air velocities up from 300 to 600 feet per minute are possible with the viscous impingement method. When the filters are clean, the pressure drop experienced is quite low, negligible, 0.1 in water gauge. But once the pressure drops below 0.5. So, right, the filtering media is coated with a resin-like sticky oily substance. The media itself is made of glass fibers and metal screens. Air velocities between 300 to 600 enabled. When the filter is clean, the pressure drop experienced is quite low, negligible, 0.1 in water gauge. But if it crosses 0.5, servicing is very essential because the filtering media is resisting a good airflow, causing a harmful impact on the air supply air inside the room. Viscous impingement method does not remove small particles, or rather the screen filters do not remove small particles. They're efficient up to 15 to 20 microns. That is considered as 90% efficiency. We are talking about the screen filters in general here. Kindly note, they are low costing, and this is an image of a viscous impingement disposable filter. They come in a frame and which is inserted at the front panel of the air conditioning unit. Second category, called as fine filters, a step beyond the pre-filters. They are used when the filtering is required to be up to 5 microns in size. And what are they comprised? How are they manufactured? They have micro layers fiberglass and asbestos. Both have the advantages of being resistant to fire and moisture. Additionally, fiberglass and asbestos are lightweight, so they have that advantage also, and they have good strength as well, good dust retention capacity. They can arrest the particles in a better manner, and we also get the cleanable types. There are two types possible. One is use and discard, disposable, and the other is reuse, a cleanable one. So cleanable ones are advisable. You can, of course, you have to put any effort to clean them, but can be reused again and again up to a certain extent. They are 99.9% efficient down to 5 microns. So good efficiency and used wherever we require this kind of filtration levels. The pressure drop 6 water gauge when clean exceeds 15 in case the pressure drop is dropping up down to 15 water gauge, it definitely needs servicing. The third category, absolute or HEPA filters, high efficiency particulate absolute filters. They are very good efficiency, high efficiency levels, dry type filters for smallest particles. Viruses as small as 0.05 micron can be arrested with a HEPA filter. They are used at air terminals, sometimes both at the return air grill and the supply terminals. The filtering media itself is a sheet of extremely fine glass fibers interwoven in diverse directions and mixed with resins. The resins will only increase the impingement of the dust particles and hold on to the filtering media rather than passing through it. So continuing with the absolute or HEPA filter, the media is pleated in the sense like that, folded, like how we pleat the sari, pleating, which increases, what is the advantage of pleating? It increases the filtering surface and at the same time minimizes the volume of the filter assembly. So imagine a sheet, if you were to pleat it, it reduces in its surface area or the space it occupies. Hence, they are pleated, very sleek sheets of filtering media, fiberglass, asbestos filtering media, pleated to increase the surface area and to minimize the volume also. To maintain a minimum and uniform distance between the various folds of the pleats, corrugated spacers are inserted in each fold. So if you see the section, you have the filtering media which runs like that, and in between you have the corrugated sheets, lightweight. Okay, they are called as the corrugated spacers to hold the pleats in place, otherwise it is going to topple. Right, and what else do we have? We have the neoprene gasket around to make it, gasket will make it foolproof. No infiltration of air. Heavy duty frame to hold this, and the whole thing is inserted in the slot where the filter has to sit. That is how a HEPA filter works. In section it is looking like that, but it is quite comfortable to be inserted. The filter media is just about 1 mm thick and resembles a white blotting paper. We must have used this in our chemistry lab during our lab sessions in the pre-university years. They are 99.97% efficiency down up to 0.3 micron and below. So that is the efficacy of the filtering media. So it is pleated that way. Corrugated sheets in between on both the ends, here and there, from that side and this side. Air is going to pass through them. Impurities get arrested there. It is inserted on a heavy duty frame and a neoprene gasket to make it foolproof. No gaps whatsoever. This is from a blog actually, but no harm in taking a look at it. A detailed HEPA filter diagram illustrates, see the pleating and the corrugated sheets in between, if you can see. So illustrates the complex inner workings of the high efficiency particulate air filters. The preferred workhorse of many COVID combating in-space air purifiers. So during COVID times, efficiency, movement to create a highly efficient filtration system is on. Because first of all, AC was a debated usage. But then there are instances where you have to use them no matter what. So filtration system has to reach up that expectation level of filtering the viruses. Continue sheet of filter media and how it so there are three ways in which a dust particle gets filtered: interception, impact and diffusion. So this is what you will see in most of the literatures or principle of HEPA filters: interception, impact and diffusion, and randomly arranged fibers. So you have various sizes of the interstices, and up to 0.3 and below you can arrest the impurities. These are safer to use in classrooms, daycare centers, fitness studios, senior living centers, business offices and more. So says the manufacturer or service provider. Then they're comparing two products. On the left, the ISO Air RSF 500, which uses a 12-inch deep high-capacity medical grade HEPA filter. 99.99% of airborne contaminants such as viruses and emerging variants. COVID-19 has seen many variants ahead. So it says that it is going to arrest them: bacteria, mold, pollen, dust and other pollutants. The competitor brand, pictured to the right, features a small 1.5-inch deep HEPA, which contain less of the protective filter media and require more frequent filter changes. So comparisons between the two, and always a product is has to match with its contemporaries. There is always debate or comparisons made between two or three products in the market, and we settle in for the best suited for us with the best efficacy possible. Finally, electronic filters, they look somewhat like that. They remove up to 95.3% of airborne particles, up to 0.3 microns. Uses electrostatically charged polypropylene and polyurethane filtration media to attract the dust particles. Air is passed through an electrostatic field strong enough to charge the particles in the airstream. So what happens when it is passed through electrostatic field? The particles become charged, themselves, positive, negative. Further, this air, now which is charged, is passed between parallel plates. One is positive charged and one is negative charged. So when you pass the charged air through the charged plates, positive dust gets attracted to negative dust, negative plate, and negative particles to the positive plate. So that's how they get arrested. So dirty air or used air passing through ionizer. Ionizer charges the air particles, positive or negative. The negatives get stuck to the positive and vice versa. Clean air comes out of the system. Positives get attracted to negative plates and vice versa, and hold on to the plates. The plates are also coated additionally with sticky adhesive, making impossible for the impurities to escape. Static voltage of 12 kilovolts is essential. Also, it has an additional advantage. If you want to remove odor, activated charcoal filters are additionally used. So you can insert the charcoal filters as a second layer of filtration. So the used air entering, this is a sequence of filters used. Pre-filter filters out the large dust particles, sieves it. Then whatever is remaining enters the ionizer field. They get charged, positive, negative. They pass through the collector plates, again getting attracted positive. If you charge the air positive, all of them, they all get attracted to the negative plates, and you can keep shuffling between the two types of ionizers. Also, you can pass them through carbon filters, charcoal filters, which will remove the odor. So the air coming out is now cleaner, cooler, odorless, odor free, and dehumidified. So this is how you can enable a good filtration methodology. So this shows that you can use a combination of filters when you need very high filtration efficiency, such as in clean rooms. So you can use pre-filter, first stage of cleaning, then you can use electrostatic, then you can use HEPA. How do we select air filters? How do we take these decisions? Because you have either permanent or disposable types. There are stationary or renewable. The degree of cleanliness needed by the user or the building activity has to be decided by noticing the contamination levels. We have to arrive at what should be the cleanliness level. Cost-based decisions also very critical. Odor removal objectives, if at all, in a given space such as a restaurant or so, we have to adhere to that or use that kind of a filtering media. Maintenance aspects, how frequently maintenance is required, what is the costing per maintenance, how hard is it to maintain by yourself, or do you need a servicing scheduled, all that. So all these parameters should make us arrive at good decision making on the filter media. This is an example of automatic renewable filter. So it's a roll, like how you go to a plotter and get your sheets plotted on an A0 size. It keeps rolling. Once it gets dirty, the sensor senses it, and the roll moves in to replace the filtering media with a new filtering surface. So these are also quite handy in large scale air conditioning systems. and where you have large spaces to be air conditioned and air filtered likewise. They are economical, by the way, and not adding to environmental waste. So let us now conclude our session on air filtration system with this quick exercise. If you can undertake a literature review on AC filtration levels and COVID-19 combat systems required indoors. So you can correlate what are the new innovations happening, how are we enabling the usage of air conditioning in these current times, what is the literature in the sense, what are the researches happening. You can pick up one or two and debate on it. Write a 500 word essay on the above, quoting all sources. Kindly correct the spelling of sources there. So you will do a review on relating COVID-19 and filtration systems and to what level the filtration system has to match up. There are people who are undertaking very, very extensive literature on this, research on this. So you can pick one or two and write a quick essay on it, maximum 5 words, and it helps in the understanding overall. So that is it. This ends lecture number 11, air filtration systems. Further, next lecture, we are going to talk about clean room air conditioning systems, clean rooms, which are the highly efficient clean spaces required. Okay, so until we meet in the next lecture, see you. Bye.